Welcome to the Hoosier Huddle preview show. I'm Lauralys Shallow, joined by Rylie Khyn and Nate Comp. This week, IU travels to the Big House. They're going to be traveling up to Michigan in a game that they need to win if they want to make it to a bowl. They're one win away. They've got Purdue the next week, but this is a game that if IU does win, it puts them in bowl contention. And if this is a game that Michigan wins, it probably puts them in a good spot headed into Ohio State and then looking into college football playoffs. So diving deeper into this matchup, Michigan's got a very talented defense. What do you think IU's going to need to do offensively to be able to move the ball against this Michigan defense?
Yeah, like you said, Michigan's defense is incredibly talented. They only give up an average of 12 points per game. I mean, clearly, they hold their opponents to low scoring. They only give up 219 total yards in total offense per game. They're the number one ranked defense in college football. IU's offense has been inconsistent all season. I think it's going to be a really tough matchup for Indiana's offense.
Yeah, I have to agree with you. I genuinely do think this is going to be the toughest defense that IU's going to see, and it's going to be on the road in a very hostile environment, and they've got a pretty young team offensively, IU, I think they will be challenged definitely by this defense. And then just moving on to the offensive side of things, Michigan's got Shea Patterson at quarterback. He's a transfer from Ole Miss. What else do you see out of this Michigan offense? Do you see them giving IU problems, or do you think IU's defense should be able to handle this offense?
Well, like you said, for years we've seen that great Michigan defense. Ever since Harbaugh got here, we've seen a very elite defense. Then on the offensive side of the ball, there were a lot of question marks. This year, that has changed a lot. With Caron Higdon and Shea Patterson holding the ball most of the time, the offense is really powerful. They've been elite as well on that side of the ball. It will be tough for Indiana's defense to keep up with this like high-powered offense, I think, all day. Higdon will get plenty of carries. He just rushed over 1,000 yards in his last game for the season. And Shea Patterson has really looked good this season. He's completing over 67% of his passes, and he's only thrown 3 interceptions all year. It'll be a tough game for the Indiana defense.
And just kind of a little bonus question for you guys. I know in recent years, IU's actually played Michigan pretty well. It's been pretty high scoring as well, forcing overtime. Do you guys see this type of game like we've seen in recent years shaping out, or do you see a blowout, or just based on your predictions, not even winner or loser, but do you see a close game, or do you see kind of a not-so-close game like we've seen in recent years?
You know, I think it could really go either way. I think it's going to depend a lot on the Indiana team that we see, because they have been inconsistent. They have played really talented teams to a higher level, and they played some not-so-talented teams to play down to their level. So I think it really just depends on the team that Indiana takes to Michigan.
Yeah, I agree. That's part of having a super young team. Like, we have 55 freshmen on this roster. There will be ups and downs in the season. This will probably be one of the most hostile environments that this Indiana team will play in, so it will be a tough game for sure.
Yeah, and you can catch that game on FS1 at 4 o'clock on Saturday. For Rylie Khyn and Nate Comp, I'm Lauralys Shallow. Thank you for watching the Hoosier Huddle Preview Show.